Ginger brown pine trees fill the whole 10 square kilometer area close to Chernobyl nuclear power plant. These woods definitely have intriguing looks, but the reason behind it is kind of gruesome. Today we will tell you a bit about an important part of the exclusion zone, the Red Forest. It is a section of exclusion zone that was severely contaminated by radiation following the disaster that happened at Chernobyl nuclear power plant on April 26, 1986. The forest got its name from the reddish color of pine trees that were growing there at the time of the disaster, which was caused by the higher levels of radiation they were exposed to. At that time, the Red Forest was located just a few kilometers from the power plant, and it was one of the areas most heavily contaminated by radiation. The trees in the forest absorbed large amounts of radiation from air, and many of them died as a result. But the surviving trees turned in a ginger brown color. In the years following the disaster, the Red Forest was considered to be one of the most contaminated areas in the exclusion zone. So at the same time, one of the most contaminated areas on the whole Earth. Back then, the Red Forest was off-limits to most people. However, in recent years, the radiation levels have decreased significantly. And now it is considered to be one of the safest areas in the exclusion zone, as surprising as it may sound. But let's speak about the direct reasons why the trees had turned this color. Ionizing radiation, such as that which was released during the Chernobyl disaster, can damage the DNA of trees and other living organisms in a number of ways. One way ionizing radiation can damage DNA is by breaking the chemical bonds that hold the DNA molecule together. When this happens, the DNA strands can become separated, and the genetic information they contain can be lost or altered. This can lead to problems with the organism's ability to grow and function properly, and may even lead to death. Ionizing radiation can also cause the formation of free radicals, which are highly reactive molecules that can damage the DNA and other cellular structures. Free radicals can react with DNA and cause changes in the genetic material, leading to mutations and other genetic abnormalities. In addition to these direct effects, ionizing radiation can also cause indirect damage to the DNA by weakening the immune system and making it more susceptible to infection and other stressors. This can further compound the damage caused by the radiation and increase the likelihood of death or other negative outcomes. Thus, ionizing radiation can weaken the trees. It can happen, for example, by damaging the cells that make up the immune system, such as immune cells. When these cells are damaged or destroyed by radiation, the organism's ability to defend itself against the infection and disease is compromised. Radiation can also affect the immune system by altering the way that immune cells function. For example, radiation can change the way they communicate with each other, which can disrupt the normal functioning of the immune system and lead, for example, to severe autoimmune reactions. Besides these direct effects, radiation can also weaken the immune system indirectly by causing stress and damage to other systems and tissues. For example, it can cause inflammation and other types of tissue damage, which can further weaken the immune system and make the organism more vulnerable to infection and disease. So, now you know how in general ionizing radiation works on living organisms. Humans have white cells, which are part of the immune system. But trees do not have them. Well, at least not in the same way that animals do. However, they do have cells that play similar roles in their immune systems, such as phytohemagglutinin cells, PHA, and papillae cells. When trees are exposed to high doses of ionizing radiation, these cells can be damaged in a very similar way to human white cells. Radiation can also affect other types of cells in the tree, such as cells in the bark, leaves, and roots. When these cells are damaged or destroyed, it can cause problems with the tree's growth and overall health, including the color of the leaves or needles. So now, you not only know where the Red Forest got its name, but why. It still remains a unique and eerie place. The trees that survived the disaster are still standing, and they have become silent guardians, grim statues reminding of Chernobyl history. They became overgrown and twisted. But there is some more cheerful information into this. The radiation levels strongly decreased over the years. And the Red Forest is now home to a variety of wildlife, including deer, wolves, wild boars, and, if you would believe the local observers, even horses. The animals have repopulated the area thanks to low human presence and they are thriving there. The Red Forest is now a popular destination for tourists visiting the Chernobyl Exclusion Zone. It offers a glimpse into the devastating impact of the nuclear disaster on the environment. It is also an important reminder of the destructive power of nuclear energy and the importance of safety and caution when working with it. I really hope you like this video. If you want to learn more about Chernobyl disaster, check out our playlist or check out the recently posted videos. In November we started a new series and this is the episode number 6. Next week's episode will be a surprise, but a welcome one. Sorry, couldn't resist. Stay safe guys and see you next week.